Anushka Bajpai. In the past, I have presented you many book reports on history, mythology and autobiographies. But today, I am going to present you the most fascinating biography about Sri Aurobindo. I am very privileged to buy this book from the Sri Aurobindo Ashram in Pondicherry. This is a biography anonymously written by a disciple or many disciples. Initially, it was written in a Gujarati language in a poetry form as Sri Arvind Dayam and is now translated into the English language by Sri Aurobindo Press and still is existing in the poetry format. Sri Aurobindo was born on 15th August 1872. He was born in Bengal to a doctor's family. As the elite of those times, his father sent him to England to have English education as he didn't like Indian education. So he was uprooted from his motherland and always urged to return. He was very intelligent. He knew many languages such as English, Greek, Latin and French, but he didn't know about his native language Bengali. After becoming an ICS, he returned to India. After he returned to India, he became a revolutionary. He started writing newspaper articles which were so cleverly written that the British couldn't even guess that it was written against them. He joined the team of Lal Bal Pal, who were the assertive nationalists amongst the Congress and believed in Indian cultural revivalism. He was the main thought behind Swadeshi movement of India. Due to this, he was jailed. In the prison, he had a spiritual awakening and this led him to become a yogi. During his spiritual journey, he became one of the biggest thinkers, philosophers, writers and poets of India. He was nominated for both Nobel Peace Prize and Nobel Prize for Literature. He became the happiest on 15th August 1947 when India became independent on his birthday. I think you should all read this book to know about our modern day sage of India, Sri Aurobindo. Happy reading and happy independence.